So let's have some questions from my side. Let's solve this few questions. First question is, find the locus of the pole of the line LX plus MY plus N equal to 0 with respect to the circle which touches y-axis at the origin. So of course, you know, there can be so many circles which can touch the y-axis at origin. So as you keep on changing the circle, as you know, the coordinates of the pole will change and it will trace a path. So you need to tell me the equation of that path. So find the locus of the pole of the line LX plus MY plus N. Remember, L, M, N are constants. For all the circles which touch the y-axis at the origin. Or should I give it as a prove that question? Prove that the locus will be, prove that the locus equation would be y times lx minus n is equal to mx square. If you're done, please type done on the chat box so that I can start the discussion with this. Done? Okay. So let's say the center of the circle which touches the y-axis is at a comma 0. And of course, we know that the radius itself will be mod of a, right? So we can write the equation of this circle as x minus a square plus y square is equal to a square. In other words, it becomes x square plus y square minus 2ax equal to 0. Right now, if I have to write the let the pole be h comma k, because I have to find the locus of the pole, I will call it as h comma k. Okay, let the pole be h comma k. So if I write the pole for this circle, okay, which touches the y-axis, okay, it will be xh plus yk minus a x plus h, right? If you simplify this, it will be h minus a plus yk minus a h equal to 0. And now we are claiming that this equation is same as lx plus my plus n equal to 0. So these two are the same equations. Right? So if that is the case, if they are the same equation, we can compare the coefficients. So h minus a by l is equal to k by m is equal to minus a h by n. Remember, I have to eliminate, a somehow, because a is something which I have introduced in my equation. Okay? So from the first equation, from this equation, I can say h is equal to a is equal to h minus lk by m, right? And from the second equation, I can say a is equal to minus nk by mh, right? So both these represent the same term, so I can equate them. So h minus lk by m is equal to minus nk by mh. Okay, let's try to simplify this. Mh minus LK is equal to minus NK by H, which is nothing but MH square minus LHX plus NK equal to zero. HK, I'm sorry. Yeah, this is K. Okay. So that becomes MH square is equal to LH minus NK. And now you generalize it. Now you generalize it by replacing your H with X and K with Y. So this gives you the equation of the locus of the pole, and I am sure it matches with the expression I given you. Yeah, Y times LX minus N is equal to MX square. So that is the correct answer. Is that fine, guys? Is it clear? Any question, please type CLR if it is clear to you, so that I can move on to the next concept. Okay. Great. Now we'll spend some time on the concept of common tangents. The concept of common tangents, right? We all know very well that you can have two types of common tangents drawn to a pair of circles. One is called the direct tangents, okay? And the other one is called the transverse tangents. Okay, so there is nothing new in this concept because you are already aware of it and you have done it multiple number of times in your junior classes as well. So what we'll do is we'll directly start this concept with the concept of we'll directly start with problem solving on this concept. So let's say the first question that comes your way is find all the common tangents to the circles x square plus y square minus 2x minus 6y plus 9 equal to 0 and x square plus y square plus 6x minus 2y plus 1 equal to 0. Remember, if these two circles are far apart from each other, that means they don't even touch, then you will get four answers for it. Two direct tangents and two transverse tangents. Okay. If at all you feel how do you get the equation of the polar? Okay. In the equation of a polar, in the previous question, it is the same concept, t equal to 0. So, Yuja, please listen to this. T equal to 0 is the equation of the polar that we have already learned. So, t equal to 0 means, what is t? T is x, x1, y, y1, g, x plus x1, f, y plus y1. Y plus y1 plus c equal to 0, right? So wherever there was an x square, I replaced it with this. I replaced it with x, x1. This I replaced with y, y1. X I replaced it with x plus x1 by 2. Are you getting it? So remember this, t equal to 0. Irrespective of whatever is the circle, you can always follow this formula. Is that fine, Sayujya? All right, guys, couple of things which I would like to remind you over here is that I don't know whether you are aware of it from the junior classes or not, but whenever you are drawing circles, two circles, okay, let's say this is one circle and this is another circle, okay, and you're drawing transverse and direct tangents. So let's say I draw direct tangents to it. Okay, like this. Okay. And you draw, first of all, you connect the center of these two circles. You realize that they'll meet this point of intersection over here. Okay. So the center of the two circles, the line drawn, the blue line will meet the direct common tangents at this point. Let's say I call this point as point. Let's say this is C1, this is C2. Let's say this is P, Q, R. Okay. So this is the P, Q, R point. Okay. Now, very important thing that you need to know over here is that, let's say this is radius R2, R1, let's say. Okay. Then you should be all aware that RQ is to RP will be equal to R2 by R1. Okay. So RQ is to RP would be in the same ratio as R2 is to R1. Right. Everybody is aware of it, I'm sure. So I just thought I would quickly recap this so that people who are not aware would now be aware of it. And let's say we draw the transverse tangents. Let's say we draw the transverse tangents. Okay. And let's say this is the point of contact. This is 90 degree. This is the point of contact. This is 90 degree. Okay. And let's say they meet at the point T over here. Okay. So let's say the transverse tangents meet the line joining the centers of the circle at T. So please be informed. Okay. Let's say I call this point as point M. This is your M. This is your N. Then this is your N. Then MT is to TN. TN will be again R1 is to R2. Will again be R1 is to R2. And so will be C1T to C2T. That again will be R1 is to R2. So you know which two triangles are similar in this case, right? So in this case, triangle C1MT will be similar to C2NT. So I'll write it down. Triangle C1MT will be similar to triangle C2NT. Okay. And in the case of direct common tangents, triangles RPC1 will be similar to triangle RQC2. So you can write various type of relationship between them. For example, you can also write RC2 by RC1 is again R1 is to R2. Is again R2 is to R1. Okay. Now, in case if it helps, we'll be using it in the required question as well. If done, please type in the equation. First, tell me the transverse tangents. That's easy to find out. So let me again write down the circles over here. So we have two circles, C1, which is x square plus y square minus 2x minus 6y plus 9 equal to 0. Okay. And we have another circle, C2. Okay. If you look at C1 can be written as x minus 1 square plus y minus 3 square, correct? So I can see x square minus 2x term and y square 6y term. So I have decided it to write like this. And extra will have 9 and plus 1. So you'll have a 1 over here. Okay. So this is a circle which is centered at 1, 3 and is having a radius of 1. Correct. So let us quickly draw a circle like that. So I'm quickly sketching a circle with center at 1, 3. So this is 1, 3, and its radius is going to be 1. Okay, so R is going to be 1. Okay, let's look into the other circle. The other circle, I can write x plus 3 the whole square, y minus 1 the whole square. An additional term that I would need will be 3 square. Okay, so it is a circle with center at minus 3 comma 1. So again, let's draw a circle, minus 3 comma 1. Okay, before that, I want to first figure out whether they are intersecting each other or not. Okay, so what is the distance between C1 and C2 centers? C1 plus C2, this has a center at, let me call it center as 1 comma 3, and this has a center at minus 3 comma 1. So the distance between will be 1 plus 3 the whole square and 3 minus 1 the whole square, which is, I think, going to be 20 plus 4, root 20. Root 20 is 2 root 5. Okay. And what is R1 plus R2? R1 plus R2 is 1 plus 3, which is equal to 4. Okay. So which is greater, 4 or 2 root 2, 2 root 5? So of course, 2 root 5 will be greater. Correct. So C1, C2 would be greater than R1 plus R2. So it's fine. They will not touch each other. So I can draw the figure like this. So you have to be very, very clear with the figures, guys. Okay. Now let's say I'm trying to draw the transverse common tangents to these two. So first, let us connect their centers. Let us connect their centers. And now I'm drawing transverse common tangents to these two. Like this. Okay. Anyways, let's draw only one of them. Let's not crowd this diagram. Let's not draw too many things which are not required. Okay. Now you know that this point T will divide C1 and C2 in the same ratio as their radius, isn't it? So we know C1 T is 2, C2 T will be in the same ratio as their radius, which is actually 3:1. Right? So T divides internally the join of C1 and C2 in the ratio of 3:1. Right? So can I find the coordinates of T? Right? Very easily I can find the coordinates of T. So you can find the coordinates of T as, so this is 3:1. So 3:1 plus 1:1 by 3:1. Correct? Hope I've not written any point as incorrectly. Sorry, minus 3. Minus 3:1. 1:3. Yeah, my bad. So 3:1 and 1:-3 by 3:1, comma 3:3 plus 1:1 by 3:1. Right? So I think T will have x coordinate as 0 and y coordinate as 10/4. 10/4 is 5/2. Okay. Now, if I have to find a tangent through T, so I'll say let the tangent drawn through T be y minus 5/2 is equal to mx minus 0. Okay. In other words, y is equal to mx plus 5/2. Now, if this is a tangent, can I say the perpendicular distance from the center will be equal to the radius? Right? So I will use the distance formula. Right? So I will find the distance of this point. I will find the distance between this line and this point. Right? So the distance between the given line which I have assumed and the center should be equal to 3, right? So let's put it into the equation. So 1 plus 3m minus 5 by 2 mod by under root of 1 plus m square is going to be 3, isn't it? Okay, so take it on the right side, square both the sides. So we'll have 3m minus 3 by 2 square is equal to 9, 1 plus m square. So I can always cancel off a factor of 9 from both the sides, which will give me this expression. Okay. Yes or no? Correct? No, guys. This would actually give you something like this: m square minus m plus 1 by 4 is equal to 1 plus m square. Correct. Now if you collect your m square, you will get 0 m square minus m minus 3 by 4 equal to 0. Correct. Which clearly implies that one value of m would be minus 3 by 4. Since this is a quadratic, right? So I should get two values of m. So one is 3 by 4. Let's say I call it m1. And the other two will be infinity. The reason being, I'm not getting my m squares were getting cancelled, right? So I very strategically wrote it as 0 m square, right? So when I wrote it as 0 m square, one of the roots automatically goes to infinity. And the other root is minus 3 by 4 because I have to get two answers from this, right? I have to get two tangents from this. So one of the tangent is having a slope of infinity. That's why that is not being shown in this given quadratic. The quadratic is getting converted to a linear there. But this 0 over here, which I have put, right, helps you to justify this slope, which is actually infinity also, right? So we can have two equations of tangents drawn through T, one being y is equal to minus 3 by 4 x plus 5 by 2. This is one of your answers. Okay. And the other answer is going to be a line having a slope of infinity and passing through 0. So that is going to be your x equal to 0. That's going to be your x equal to 0 line. Yes or no? Yes or no? So these are the answers to the transverse tangents. So these are your transverse tangents. Is the idea clear? This is very important because many people would not account for this. So you can have a slope of infinity of a line. So infinity is an accepted answer for M. Is that fine, guys? Now, I want you to tell me what would be the direct tangents or direct common tangents to this circle. So in case of direct common tangents, guys, you'll be drawing these two tangents. Okay. And I need this point first. So this point is basically extension of this only. So if you extend the centers, it will meet at a point. Let's say I call this as direct for D for direct. Okay. What is the coordinates of D? If you can tell me that, my 90% work will be done. So please type in your screen on your chat box. What is the coordinates of D? Coordinates of D, guys, fast. Aryan, Apmesh, Arun, Snigdha, Tapas, Mathli, Shreyas. Guys, wake up. Tell me the coordinates of D. So think as if C1, C2 are these two points. D is here. Okay. And this ratio is 3:1. 3:1. So minus 3, 1, and this is 1, 3. So it's a case of external division, right? So tell me the formula for external division. You can take the ratio to be 3:-1 because it's a case of external division. So 3:-1. So answer will be 3:1 and -1 × -3, which is equal to 3 again by 3 - 1, comma. Then we can write 3 × 3, which is 9, and -1 × -1, which is going -1 × 1, which is -1 by 3 - 1. Yeah, so it's going to be 6/2, comma 8/2, which is going to be 3, 4. So coordinates of 3 is 3, 4. Guys, very saddening to see that you people are not able to find the external division point. Okay. Once you've got this point 3, 4, you can write the equation of a tangent. Let the direct common tangent be y - 4 = mx - 3. Okay. And then again, you can use the fact that it is tangent to any one of the circle. Let's say I take the tangent from 1, 3. So distance of this line from 1, 3 should be 1 unit. Okay. So let's write it as y = mx + 4 - 3m. So distance from 1, 3 should be equal to 1 unit. So when you write the distance, you will get the expression as 3 - m + 3m - 4 mod / √1 + m² is equal to 1. Okay. Which gives you 2m - 1² is equal to 1 + m². So 4m² - 4m + 1 is equal to 1 + m². 1 cancels off. So 3m² is equal to 4m. So m could be 0 or m could be 4/3. So putting it back over here, so two equations of the direct common tangents will be y = 4 when you put m as 0, and when you put it as 4/3, it becomes 4/3x + 4 - 4, which is 0. So it becomes y = 4x/3. So this is your second direct common tangent drawn to the circle. Guys, please type CLR on the screen if it is clear to you. I don't think so it is clear. You are not able to get a single answer correct, guys. Pretty disappointing performance. Given that your JEE is just 1.5 months away, this is not how you should be behaving. You are unable to find the external point. It appears that I am writing JEE for you.